Sometimes those little diagrams make you think that it's the presynaptic neuron talking only to the postsynaptic neuron, and that's not really the whole story. In many ways, you're having the genome of A, the top neuron, talking to the genome of B. So that's really where all the information is. So the computer headquarters of all the brains, essentially, of the neuron, that's kind of an interesting way of looking at it. Neurons are your brains. But if each neuron has a command center, you really are having the first neuron wanting to talk to the second neuron, command center to command center. Now at the top, you have reception in kind of green. And what that means is all sorts of stuff can make messaging to a neuron. A hormone, a drug, nerve impulses from every place, neurotransmitters, of course, and even light in some light-sensitive neurons can actually create a message. And what ends up happening is all this stuff's coming in because you have that big dendritic tree and thousands of inputs, and the neuron integrates those and chemically encodes them. Because you're going to get some contrary stuff. Yes, fire, no, don't fire. Well, two fires and one no fire, 20 fires and one no fire, then guess what predominates? And that sort of a thing. And then after you integrate that, you encode it into, yes, I'm going to fire. No, I'm not going to fire. And so if you encode it and say, okay, I'm going to fire, that happens right here at the initial segment of the axon of the first neuron. So let's say the input has come and it says, yes, let's fire. And then the fuse is lit. And the neuron goes bing, 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 all the way down till it gets down to the bottom. And then it releases neurotransmitter. So the electrical encoding goes to signal. That signal is propagated as an electrical signal. And then it gets transduced from electrical to chemical. And that means neurotransmitter. So the neurotransmitter in this case has traversed across the synapse to talk to that green platform down there on B, and that's going to be one of the inputs. And if it's strong enough to be integrated in that neuron, it could cause a signal, which could be propagated to gone down to the bottom of it. So that's kind of, in a nutshell, what it's like.